Hello students, so in today's lecture we will discuss about the fifth unit, that is data visualization. So in this data visualization we will discuss about what exactly the data visualization is and the techniques used for data representation, visual data representation, types of data visualization, applications of data visualization, and some tools and the one essential software that is used for data visualization, that is Tableau. Okay, so related to Tableau software, so this entire content which makes your fifth unit called data visualization. Okay, so let's see what is data visualization. So before that, we will try to understand what is visualization. Any idea what is visualization? So every human being has a characteristic of visualizing something, okay, according to his perception, what exactly he understands. So if he is able to represent that particular visualization in some form, that can be called as visualization. Okay, so some, what can say, yeah, that is to be represented, some concept is to be represented. So with respect to this, we can say that visualization can be some, what you can say, a pictorial form. The concept can be represented in a pictorial form, in some visual form. So visual form or pictorial form means anything that we can think of, like it can be a graph, it can be a some flow diagram, it can be your flow chart, it can be your data flows diagrams, it can be your bar charts, it can be a map, something like that. Okay, so whatever the concept that we are able to visualize in the form of picture can be thought of as the visualization. Okay, so ultimately in this particular case our aim is to represent the textual information in some visual form. That is the main objective here. Okay, so why this kind of interpretation or visualization is required? So there is a saying, okay, so as you people are already studied the computer graphics, with that particular thing I can say that 1000 words is equal to one picture. Okay, so this particular statement explains everything about the visualization. Okay, so as an human being, instead of reading pages of text, okay, so if that particular thing can be put in some pictorial form or pictorial representation and visual representation, that can be more appealing to the human being. One can easily interpret, okay, easily grasp what exactly the objective of the author is, what exactly the opponent wants to say, something like that. Okay, so this is what, and also we as a human being, we understand the visual representation much better than the textual description. Okay, so with respect to that, the visualization in big data gains much more importance nowadays. So to continue with this visualization, we can say that, or it can be defined as a pictorial or visual representation technique. Anything which is represented in a pictorial or graphical form with the help of diagrams, charts, pictures, flowcharts, etc., can be thought of as a visualization. Data represented in the form of graphics can be analyzed better than the data presented in words. Okay, so this is the much better word to describe what you can say your visualization. So data visualization is a pictorial or visual representation of data with the help of visual aids such as graphs, bars, histograms, tables, your pie charts, mind maps, etc. Depending upon the complexity of data, the aspects from which it is being analyzed, visuals can vary in terms of their dimensions. Okay, means what? Depending on the objective and the complexity of the study, complexity of data, the different forms or different visualization tools can be used. It can be a temporal, hierarchical, network, etc. So the dimensions can be a 1D, one dimensional, two dimensional, three dimensional pictures can be utilized. Different types of tools are available in the market nowadays for visualizing the data. One of the most commonly used data visualization tool is Tableau. So which is available for free as a Tableau Public. We can use Tableau products for both individual as well as corporate purposes, creating several types of one dimensional, two dimensional and three dimensional visualization. Okay, so now in this particular entire unit, we need to understand what is the use of data visualization in big data. Okay, so this is what we need to understand here. Okay, let us, with this introduction, let us move further. So as I have told, we need to understand what is data visualization and why it is being used in big data, why it is required. Okay, so these were the two points that we want to address in this case. So let us define what exactly this data visualization is. So as I have already told, data visualization is a pictorial or visual representation of data with the help of visual aids. Okay, with the help of visual tools. It is a type of data representation. Data is represented in the form of pictures or the visuals. So in this particular case, what I mean by data? So in this case, in big data concept, the data is in the form of data sets. So we have a huge amount of data sets are available. So those data sets to be analyzed and represented in the form of data visualization for better understanding purposes. Okay. So this is what the meaning of data visualization. So as in the slide, it says that this data visualization conveys information through visual representation. Okay. So here the main motto, whatever the software that we use, our data visualization software that we use, its main motto is that how the information to be represented in an effective pictorial form, in a visual form. This data visualization produces visual representations of an abstract data to reinforce human cognition, thus enabling the viewer to gain knowledge about the internal structure of the data and causal relationship within it. Okay, so data set is a huge file. So from that, we need to abstract what exactly the objective or meaning of that particular file, that particular data set, and also we try to identify the relationship between the different parameters depending on the objective of a study. Okay, so this is what your data visualization concept put forth or represents or provides to the, what you can say, the analyst. Right, so as I have already pointed out that data visualization can be a pictorial or visual representation of data with the help of visual aids such as graphs, bars, histograms, tables, pie charts, mind maps. So any kind of such elements can be used to represent the data sets. Fine. So let us continue. So let us, after defining visualization and data visualization, next concept is, what are the different ways of representing the data? Okay, so in this particular case, we have two different techniques to represent the data. So we'll come back to this slide later. So first one is infographics and second one is data visualization. So these were the two techniques which are used to represent the visual data. Okay, so in this particular case, what is an infographic? Okay, so infographic is a way of representing the visual data. So using this visual infographic and the data visualization, the data is analyzed and then the result of that analysis is presented in any of these particular forms, either infographics or data visualization. So infographics are the usual representation of information or data rapidly and accurately. Okay, so visual representation of data is done in this particular case very rapidly and efficiently. So here, this particular infographic, it looks something like this. Just analyze this particular. So what are all things it consists of? So this is one kind of infographic. So here it is a librarian infographic. So library information is present here. So you already know what exactly the library is. So before going much details of that particular thing, okay, so let us concentrate on what exactly the contents of infographic. So looking at this particular infographic, we can say that it consists of some kind of data related to library, okay, if that is the objective. It consists of textual information. It consists of images. There are various, what you can say, the descriptors have been used there. Okay, so all these components, not only the text, apart from the text, many icons, images are present in this particular case. Okay, this is what the infographic is. So infographic consist of data, icons, images, text that work together to tell a story. So all these are effectively combined by the analyst to make an effective story of an objective. This is what your infographic. So infographic is always has a certain purpose and action, call of action. So in this infographic, it presents both objective and solution also. Okay, so means everything is described in this particular case using data, icons, images, text, etc. Okay, so the story of a creator, okay, is been entirely put or presented, represented in this infographic form. So we can say that the infographics are visual representations of information or data rapidly and accurately. The use of colorful graphics in drawing charts, graphs, helps in improving the interpretation of a given data. Okay, so all these, any of these particular tools you can make use to make your presentation, your infographic more attractive. Okay, so it also consists of various, what you can say, the objectives or the elements. It can consist of map, which showcases data trends based on the location. It consists of description like versus, means the comparison statement of two different things, you can say, two different competitors, you can say, depending on the objective. So that also can be presented in an infographic. Okay, so versus compares two things in a head-to-head study. It can also consist of timeline, which tells a story through a chronological flow. Means what? A complete life cycle of an event can be depicted, can be included in a infographic. It may also consist of lists, a list of items, supports a claim through a series of steps, a list of steps, a list of items, a list of components can be included. It can consist of flowchart also, which provides a specialized answer to a question via reader choices. Okay, so as I already told, it presents both objective and the solution part. Okay, so for that particular reason, the flowcharts can be utilized. And also it consists of visual articles, which makes a piece of writing more visual. Okay, so all these components are put together to form a infographic. Okay, infographic. So this is what the infographic is. Right, so let us see now what exactly your data visualization. So data visualization communicates data through charts, graphs, and some kind of design. That's it. Okay, so this visualization is much simpler than the infographic. Infographic consists of everything, whereas data visualization just consists of some charts, graphs, and the design, nothing else. No text or nothing is what you can say used in this particular case. Okay, so this is one more kind of data visualization. So let us go back to this earlier slide. So after defining it in an abstract manner, let us see what is the similarities and the difference between the two ways of representing the visual data. So infographics and the data visualization both usually represent the data and accessible to audience. Okay, the motto, the objective of both these techniques or types is same. That is how best to visualize the data and represent it to the user. This is the main objective. Okay, but the ways of representing that particular data is something different in both the cases. Whereas in infographics are created for a reason and purpose which is subjective, can contain data visualization qualitative elements and advocacy. Means it consists of both images, text, icon, various comparison statements, everything that is put together to form a infographic. Whereas the data visualization is just an objective. It is not subjective, it's objective. It is just an objective. Its aim is to present what exactly the meaning or the objective or the purpose of that particular problem study. That's it. Data visualization should be objective, with all data represented, unedited, quantitative, massive, no context. So as it has been, whatever the data is there, so that has been represented in the form of bar charts or some kind of design. No textual or images, particular means that the different kind of images have been put together to form it, what you can say, the infographic there. It is not like infographic. Okay, so infographic we can think of something like a poster that you create for an event. Okay, so which consists of everything, whereas this particular data visualization is just what you can say, a highlighting part. Okay, what exactly the objective is. By looking at that particular pictorial representation, one can easily understand what exactly the author wants to convey. Okay, so it presents just a summary in the form of visual representation. That's it. It doesn't contain any text and all. Okay, this is what the data visualization is. So to continuing with this data visualization, which is different approach from the infographics, it is the study of representing data or information in a visual form. With the advancement of digital technologies, the scope of multimedia has increased manifold, as you are already aware. Visuals in the form of graphs, images, diagrams, and animations have completely proliferated the media industry and the internet. It is an established fact that the human mind can comprehend information more easily if it is presented in the form of visuals. Instructional designers focus on abstract and model-based scientific visualizations to make the learning content more interesting and easy to understand. Nowadays, scientific data is also presented through digitally constructed images. These images are generally created with the help of computer software. Okay? So computer software is very essential for data visualization, and also nowadays we have different kinds of organization where each of these different domains generating a huge amount of data. It can be a financial organization, it can be a scientific research organization, it can be the defense organization, it can be a governmental organization, it can be a banking sector. So many the sectors and domains are there which are generating huge amount of data which is to be analyzed and represented in a proper form. That's why the data visualization has been coined. Okay, so now so far we have understood what exactly the data visualization is and what are the different ways in which the data can be visualized, that is using infographic or the data visualization. So our main focus is on data visualization rather than infographic. Okay, so let us see why we should go for data visualization. So the main goal of the data visualization is to answer the questions. Okay, so we have a huge amount of data, so now it has been given to an analyst to answer the questions raised by the user. Okay, so for this particular reason we need an data visualization tools. And to discover something new, okay, so it is a random data. Today we can discover something new. And also visualizations mainly used to make the decisions in an enterprise. This is a very important goal of data visualization. Okay, so definitely the devices, the various procedures of an organization are generating huge amount of data. Okay, so nowadays we have online data and also offline data. So how these particular data is to be grabbed and analyzed for the betterment of the enterprise, this is the major aspect. Then also visualization, see the data in context. Okay, so whatever the data that we are having, organization is having, it should be fitted in some context. Okay, so once we analyze, once we better understand the parameters of that particular data set, then it is the analyst job becomes much easier to relate some context with respect to that organization. He can fit that particular data to the enterprise concept context, you can say. Okay, support graphical calculations, yes, of course. So we have a huge amount of data, so that should be represented in some pictorial form. So graphical calculations can be much easier with respect to the visualization is concerned. Also, visualizations identify different patterns. Okay, so this is also a very important, what you can say, the goal of the data visualization. So by identifying the different patterns, one can easily understand and understand the system data, as well as he can better able to make the decision about that particular data. And one can easily present the argument or tell a complete story of that particular data. Okay, so this is very important from analyst point of view. And all these particular things results or inspires the people in the organization. Okay, so depending upon the where exactly the organization is heading can be what you can say represented using this visualization tool, okay, which ultimately inspires what you can say the employers there. Okay, so these are the major what you can say the visualization goals. For these particular reasons we need what you can say the data visualization. Visualization is an excellent medium to analyze, comprehend and share information. So why this data visualization is an excellent medium to analyze, comprehend and share information? Okay, so that has been what you can say shown in this particular slide. So these visualizations or visual images help to transmit huge amount of information to the human brain at a glance. Okay, so to describe this particular point, okay, I want to recall the statement what we have made in the beginning of this class. Okay, 1000 words is equal to 1 picture. Okay, so if I give you a pages of text, okay, and also a summary of that particular text in a one picture or one image, then we normally prefer to view an image rather than reading a page full of text. Okay, so this is what, okay, so our human brain actually perceives the images or the pictures very quickly, so that's why the data visualization is gaining much importance. So visual images help in transmitting a huge amount of data or information to the human brain at a glance. So by looking at that thing, one can easily understand what exactly that picture means. Help in establishing the relationship and distinction between different patterns and processes easily. Okay, so as I have told, the relationship and the distinction between the different patterns, different attributes of the data, okay, so this is very important. That can be visualized and presented much better using these visualization tools. It helps in exploring the data. Definitely we can explore the data here. Helps in identifying problems and understanding trends and outliers. Okay, so this is where the organizations play an important role. Okay, for this particular objective is very important to the enterprise is concerned, organizations is concerned. Okay, so they want to understand how the trend is. Okay, how the trend about their product, how the trend about their pricing. Okay, so there are lots of policy will run around. Okay, so they want to understand the trend of all those particular things. Okay, and also they want to identify the outliers. Okay, so how we are different. Okay, so this is one aspect of outlier. What are all the elements that are present in an organization? Am I deviating from the mainstream? Okay, so all these particular things can be analyzed in this particular case, okay, using visual aids. So this is very important for identifying the trends, patterns and the outliers. And also it highlights or points out key or interesting breakthroughs in a large data set. So definitely, okay, So we are understanding the relationship between parameters and all. So from that, the large data set can be easily interpreted presented in a visual form. So this is why we need, what you can say, the data visualization is. So after understanding this, why this visualization is, next, based on these particular things, data can be classified using three criteria, irrespective of whether it is presented as data visualization or infographic. Okay, so the data is classified as per that is, first one is method of creation, quantity of data displayed, degree of creativity that has been applied. Okay, so these particular things, these three points are very important for the analyst purpose. Okay, so he need to have a clear understanding of this particular thing. Okay, so what is the method of creation? I have a huge amount of data set, huge amount of data. Okay, so how I want to present it? What is the goal? What is the objective? So if I ask these questions to myself, okay, the analyst will identify what is my method of creation. Okay, that is the answer. Then the next one is quantity of data displayed. Okay, so I am in this particular case, how much of data I want to convey in my data visualization techniques. So limiting factor is very important here. How I summarize the data, where I should stop, whatever is there, I cannot go on putting everything in my the data visualization. So where I should limit. So this particular judgment is very important for the data analysis concern. Then degree of creativity applied. Okay, I have identified a method of display. I have identified where to limit myself. I have identified clear cut goals and objective. And after that, how I want it to be more creative, more presentable. So which are the elements that I am looking for so that I can better present this particular data? So this particular judgment is degree of creativity that can be applied. Okay, so depending on this, the analyst is going to divide or categorize the data. Okay, so let us put more light on this particular thing. So method of creation, actually it refers to the type of content used while creating any graphical representation. Then second one, quantity of data displayed, it refers to the amount of data which is represented. Okay, for example, you can use geographical map, company's financial data, etc. Okay, and a degree of creativity, that is third one, degree of creativity applied, it refers to the extent to which the data is created graphically or designed in a colorful way, or it is just showing some important data in black and white diagrams. Okay, so these are the the classification or criteria on which the data can be classified. On this basis, we can understand which is the correct form of representation for a given data type. Okay, so we have different kinds of data types here. So depending on the type of the data, we can use graphs, diagrams, timeline, we have templates, checklist, flowchart, mind map. So these are the certain components that can be used to represent these above mentioned three, the kind of data. So coming to graph, it is a, as you already know, it is a representation in which X and Y axis are used to depict the meaning of information. Second component, diagram, is the two-dimensional representation of information to show something works. Timeline, it's a representation of important events in sequence with the help of self-explanatory visual material. Okay, so timeline, it's just what you can say, it shows a complete schedule of an event. So this is one more type of what you can say, the component that can be used. Next one is checklist. So this template. So this template is a kind of layout which is nothing but designed for presenting the information. Okay, so some kind of framework. So within that particular framework, we are identifying different fields and we want to make that particular template more effective in our data visualization. Then next component is checklist. A list of items for comparison and verification can be included in this case. Flowcharts can be included, which is a representation of instructions which shows how something works or step-by-step procedure to perform the task. And also mind maps can be included, which is a type of diagram which is used to usually organize the information. Okay, so overall all these tools helps us to what you can say organize the data depending on the objective that we want to meet. Okay, so these are the various content types that we can include in our data visualization. Fine. Okay, so after understanding this, next slide discusses about the techniques used for visual representation. What are the different techniques that are available so that we can better interpret or describe the data that is in our hand? Okay, so there are various techniques are available. Means these are all the techniques, the tools which are present in our, what you can say, supported by our computer software. So data can be presented in various visual forms, which include simple line diagrams, bar graphs, tables, matrices, etc. So for some of the techniques used for visual representation, so are shown in this particular slide. So amongst that, the first one is isoline. First one is isoline. So this is one type of what you can say, the visual aid that we can use. So this isoline is a 2D data representation of a curved line that moves constantly on surface of a graph. The plotting is an isoline is based on data arrangement rather than the data visualization. Okay, so these are the curved areas. Okay, these are the curves which represents the data. So in this particular, so this type of what I can say, the visualization usually used to represent your temperatures, wind speeds, meteorological data. Okay, your what I can say, the weather forecasting data. So all these particular things can be represented using this kind of a technique, that is isoline. Next one is isosurface. So isosurface looks something like this. By looking at this figure, you can easily understand that it is an 3D representation. So isoline is a 2D representation, whereas isosurface is a 3D representation of data. So this isosurface is a 3D representation of isoline. Isosurfaces are designed to represent points that are bound by a constant value in a volume space. Okay, so volume space means especially the 3D space. So actually it is used to represent the what you can say, the chemistry, geography, what you can say, geophysics, okay, it is extensively used there to represent the pressure, temperature, velocity, density. Okay, so wherever the volume of space comes into picture, so these particular representation or techniques are used. And also it is used in medical imaging, like a CT scan for internal, what you can say, the organs, CT scan of internal organs and also the bones. Okay, bones. So in such areas, this kind of techniques are very popular. Then the next one is direct volume rendering, that is known as DVR. So this DVR, it is a method of method used for obtaining a 2D projection for a 3D data set. Okay, so this is from 3D to 2D conversion, that is called as a direct volume rendering. A 3D record is projected in a 2D form through DVR for a clearer and more transparent visualization. Okay, so this is also one of the effective tool in this particular case. So 3D data can be converted to a 2D representation, something like this. Okay, so 3D means we have three space axes, x, y, z, and 2D means x and y axis. Okay, so we can fit the data from three axes to two axes using this particular technique. Next one is streamline. So this streamline technique, which is a field line that results from the velocity vector field description of that data flow. Okay, so velocity vector field description can be shown in this particular case, looks something like this. Okay, so as I have already told that this particular type of technique is very much used in our medical line and also for what you can say the physics, especially the physics what you can say the volume representation, velocity representation. Okay, so for scientific data representations, this streamlines are effectively used. Then the next one is map, which is an usual visual representation within a specific area. It is depicted on a planar surface. Okay, so a particular location can be what you can say represented using the map technique. So one Google map, okay, example that has been shown. So any particular location can be pointed out or represented using this particular technique. The next one is parallel coordinate plot. It is a visualization technique of representing multidimensional data. It is used to represent the n-dimensional data, that is parallel coordinate plot. So again, this particular kind of technique very much popular in scientific data representations and also the demographic calculations, meteorological survey. Okay, so these are the various areas, and also in medical field this kind of what you can say the n-dimensional coordinate plots are used to represent the data. The next one is Venn diagram. So these Venn diagrams are much popular, and already you are aware of what exactly the use of Venn diagrams. So these Venn diagrams are actually used on to represent the different sets of data. It is used to represent the logical relationship between the finite collections of data. Okay, so for if we can take help of this particular technique, then what you can say all these particular technique is not exactly the compulsion that we should use. It depends on the type of the data that we have and also the objective which we want to meet. So these are the various techniques that are available for our disposal to represent the data. Then after Venn diagram, we have a timeline there. So it is used to represent chronological display of events. So chronological display of events can be represented this using this timeline technique. So actually timeline in especially for our software engineers, okay, this timelines we deal with these particular terms on regular basis. Okay, so if you see, you are a project management. So in the project management, when you take a project, okay, so from that particular point onwards till the delivery of that particular project, you schedule, you lay the milestone. Okay, so your, what you can say, the end user wants to know when you are going to provide that particular, what you can say, the software to me. So for that particular, till the inception to end delivery date, so you identify certain milestone. Okay, so in this particular, after 1 month, okay, so we are going to complete this. So in next 6 months, this is our status. So in 8 months of time, we are going to complete the project and delivering to you. Okay, so these are milestones. Okay, so chronological ordering of events, if that particular thing is required, in that particular case, timeline technique is to be used. So in this particular figure, just I have shown one timeline for coronavirus. Okay, so since from what you can say, at December 2019 to till today, whatever the things happens, so that has been what you can say, the in time wise, that has been the events have been mentioned there. So it is a timeline which clearly shows the schedule of events. Then next we have Euler diagrams, which is a representation of relationship between the sets. So this is one more way of what you can say, the representing the different sets. Okay, so we want to identify the attributes of the different sets, which are coming common, which are not common. So all these particular things can be better analyzed using the Euler diagrams. So this is also one more technique that is available for the analyst for his data analysis. Next comes hyperbolic trees. So these hyperbolic trees represent graphs that are drawn using hyperbolic geometry. So these particular type of hyperbolic trees are especially used for displaying hierarchical data. Okay, so if you want to organize data in a hierarchical fashion, then this particular technique can be used, that is hyperbolic trees. Then the next one is cluster diagram. It represents a cluster such as cluster of astronomic entities. Okay, so here in this particular case, we have different clusters have been shown in this case. Okay, whatever the data is there, so I want, depending on the attributes, I want to cluster them together. Okay, so this is the objective. So in that particular case, I need to identify a group of components which possesses the same attributes. Okay, so this is one of the objective. Means what? Using this cluster diagram, we can easily cluster the data points. Okay, so this is one more technique that is available for our disposal. Then finally, the last one, that is 12th technique, which is called as ordinogram. It is used to analyze various sets of multivariate objects. Okay, so various multivariate objects can be what you can say, better diagrammed using this ordinogram. So especially this particular ordinogram concept is used in scientific analysis, scientific data analysis, and also the quality of soil testing. Okay, so in those particular fields, these ordinograms are very much used. So these are the various techniques that are available for visual data representations. So I hope these particular things are clear. So we have clearly defined what is visualization, data visualization, ways of representing the data visualization, and also what you can say the various why the data visualization is required, and various techniques used for visual data representation. Okay, so with this I think we will wind up today. So in the next class we will continue with the same unit concepts in the next class. Thank you.